Hello everyone, and welcome to this webinar series entitled Model-Based Design for Predictive Maintenance. My name is Francesco Aldericio, and I'm an application engineer at the MathWorks. Today I'd like to take you on a very exciting journey with me, and the journey we're going to go on together is about developing and deploying predictive maintenance algorithms for a flow pack machine. A flow pack machine, as you can see, is basically part of a packaging machine. And all it does is pushing boxes and packets on a conveyor belt. So, as you might imagine, it's very important that we are able to detect if there is any abrupt fault on the electrical side or on the mechanical side. And it's also very important to know how much time we have before this machine fails. So the journey we're going to go on together is this one. So we're going to start from using a Simulink model as a digital twin to generate synthetic failure data. And then we're going to use this data and we're going to pre-process it a little bit. After pre-processing the data, we're going to extract what we will call condition indicators. So essentially, condition indicators are features. So it's basically useful information that is able to describe and summarize the health condition of our system. We will use such condition indicators to build a couple of models. In particular, we're going to build a classification model that we will use to detect and distinguish between electrical faults or mechanical faults, or maybe both. And then also we're going to use the condition indicators to build a remaining useful life estimation model. And this model will essentially tell us how much time we have before with a certain probability the machine fails. And then we're going to jump to the last step, which is deployment. So, you know, eventually what we want to do, we want to bring the algorithms that we have developed in MATLAB and Simulink onto some real hardware, or anyway into the real environment. And with respect to this, we're going to take a look at a couple of workflows. So the first workflow is deploying the condition monitoring algorithm onto a PLC through automatic code generation. And then the second workflow we're going to look at is deploying the remaining useful life estimation as a standalone application or as a web app that then we can distribute to people without a MATLAB license. So before we go on, let me just briefly summarize what kind of questions predictive maintenance can answer. So the first kind of question is very simple and is basically answering a question like, is my machine working well or not? And this is what we will call anomaly detection. Then we can take this a step further and we can look at condition monitoring. So with predictive maintenance algorithms, we can essentially understand what is not working in the real system and why. And in particular, in our case, we're going to see how we can build models that can detect and diagnose failures on the servo motor, so the electrical side, and the gearbox, so the mechanical side. And finally, prognostics can answer questions like how much time I have before my machine fails. And to do this, we're going to build a predictive algorithm. In particular, it's a remaining useful life estimation algorithm that will tell us how much time we have before the bearing system fails. So now let's go grab a cup of coffee and let's get started.